As we know, this is the season to give thanks. So today we're going to be reading a book called Gracias, Thanks. And it's written bold by Pat Mora. Ilustraciones and illustrations by John Barra. So this is a special book because it's bilingual. Bilingual means that it's written in more than one language. So I'm going to be reading the book, and some parts are going to be in Spanish and some parts are going to be in English, okay? The same parts will be translated, so you won't miss anything. You'll be getting the book in both Spanish and English. So if you don't know Spanish, just listen and see if you can figure out some things that I'm saying, okay? Por el sol que me despierta y no permite que siga durmiendo por años y años, y que me crezca una larga barba blanca, gracias. For the sun that wakes me up so I don't sleep for years and years, and grow a long white beard, thanks. So what's he thankful for? He's thankful for the sun that wakes him up every morning. Por la mariquita que se posó en mi dedo, una pequeña sorpresa, voladora, roja, gracias. For the ladybug that landed on my finger, a little red flying surprise, thanks. Why is he thankful for the ladybug? Por las olas espumosas que nos persiguen a mí y a mi hermana, y a veces corren hacia nosotros con un rápido plaf, gracias. For the foamy waves that chase my sister and me, and sometimes dash after us with a fast splash, thanks. What is he thankful for here? Por las abejas que no me picaron, convirtieron en un alfiletero, gracias. For the bees that didn't sting me and turned me into a pincushion, thanks. He's thankful that the bees didn't sting him. Would you be thankful for that? Por abuelita que siempre me guiña y me da un dólar cuando nadie nos está mirando. Gracias. For abuelita who always winks and gives me a dollar when nobody's looking. Thanks. He's thankful for his grandma. She gives him money secretly, huh? How many of you have a grandma like that? Or maybe an aunt or an uncle. Por mi amigo Billy, que me enseñó el libro sobre el niño gigante que pone a sus padres pequeñitos en la cima de un gran árbol cuando ellos se portan mal. Gracias. For my friend Billy, who showed me the book about a boy giant who puts his little parents on top of a tall tree when they misbehave. Thanks. You think he enjoys that book? Yeah, he's thankful for that, huh? Por los gusanos que atrajeron al gran pez que tiró de mi hilo de pescar. Gracias. Que tiró de mi hilo de pescar. Gracias. For the worms that brought the big fish to tug on my line. Thanks. So he's thankful for the worms that helped him catch this fish. Por mi hermanito, que le lanzó su puré de chícharos a mi hermana y me hizo reír tanto que me caía de la silla. Gracias. For my little brother who threw mashed peas at my sister and made me laugh so hard I fell off my chair. Thanks. Por mamá que encontró mi tarea en la basura. Gracias. For mom who found my homework in the trash. Thanks. Por la música de mi tío y su guitarra que convierte a nuestros perros en cantantes aulladores. Gracias. For the music of my uncle and his guitar that turns our dogs into howling singers. Thanks. Por mi familia que aplaudió y siguió aplaudiendo cuando me caí en el escenario durante nuestra obra de teatro escolar. Gracias. For my family who clapped and clapped even when I tripped on the stage in the school play. Thanks. Oh, family's always there for you, huh? Por el chocolate que papá derrite hasta que se convierte en un líquido espeso que llamamos lodo tibio cuando lo vertemos sobre el helado de vainilla. Gracias. For the chocolate dad melts into thick syrup we call warm mud when we pour it on vanilla ice cream. Thanks. Whoa, look at that. They're thankful for the chocolate. Por mis pijamas viejos, tan suaves que me siento como si me estuviera poniendo aire. Gracias. For my old pajamas, so soft, they feel like I'm putting on air. Thanks. Por el grillo escondido que nos canta una serenata antes de dormir. Gracias. For the cricket hiding when he serenades us to sleep. Thanks. He's thankful for the cricket because he sings a little song while he's going to sleep. Look at the beautiful flowers. I love the illustrations in this book. I love him so much. Let's take a look at the illustrations again. So he's thankful for his pajamas, for the chocolate, for his family who kept cheering him on even after he fell, for his uncle and his guitar who makes the dogs sing, for his mom who found his homework in the trash can. For his little brother who made him laugh when he threw peas on his sister's head. For the worms that helped him catch this big fish. For his friend who showed him this book. For his grandma who winks at him and gives him money when nobody's looking. For the bees that didn't sting him. For the foamy waves that he gets to play on with his sister, play in with his sister. For the ladybug that landed on his finger and gave him a nice surprise. And for the sun that wakes him up every morning. So today you're going to be doing a craft and you're going to be thinking about things that you are thankful for. So like the boy in the story, he's thankful for many things in his life, right? I want you to think about right now, what's something that you're thankful for? Remember we talked about that this is the season to give thanks and to think about all the awesome things we have in our life. So what are you thankful for?